Hello. Good morning, everybody. And then thank you very much for the International Society for the Tropical Forest who invite and already organized the symposium this morning. I want to introduce myself. This is my name is Hasbi Hasbila. I am Executive Director of Tropical Forest Foundation Indonesia. I have started working with the Tropical Forest Indonesia since early of 2000. That's mean already more than 20 years. I working with them, and the first time we introduce of the Tropical Forest Foundation Indonesia to introduce the new technology, new approach by how to implementation reduce impact logging to improve of the capacity, to improve of the technical, to improve of the benefit for the financial and also for the ecological. TFF Indonesia start with the first funding from the USAID. That's mean USF give us a funding to do the training for the consortium Indonesia. And that time, TFF Indonesia is collaboration with the Indonesian Concession Association, especially in the natural forest. The main activity of TFF Indonesia is the training reduce impact logging. And the same time also we facilitate of the a company, especially of the natural forest concession, to achieve of the sustainable forest management. And then at that time also, many of standard already applied in Indonesia, because that the many questions, many requests from the international market to guarantee that the wood product come from the well-managed forest. And then the TFF Indonesia is TFF is very unique organization, because this the we have the number of program in the region, and then the Indonesia we start the independent with TFF Indonesia since 2010, because that look like that the we can do independently, because that the sum of funding can be especially for Indonesia, especially for the from the ITTO, because ITTO is the looking for the developing country who can introduce of the new technology, who can demonstrate of the how to improve of the capacity, how to improve the quality of the forest management in Indonesia. The Indonesia TFF Indonesia. In the region, and that time, the managed by the Mr. Art Klassen, we are a representative of the TFF in the South Asia and Pacific program. But most of the country we involve in Indonesia, in the Pacific, we involve in the Papua New Guinea, Malaysia, Myanmar, and also in the Thailand. Then TFF Indonesia already trained, I think there's more than 1,000 people, because we trained, this is almost 100 of the concession Indonesia. Because we are training a model is very different than other organization. We train and we go to the field in the concession camp. We don't have the develop the training in the center, but we go every a concession field, because some concession can be sent up there like the 20 or 30 people, because that the involved in the so many different department, especially for the planning, operational, and also for the research and development, because we training the staff how to make the good plan, how to make up the efficiency operational, include how to efficiency using of the machine for the logging operation. And then with this training, we do the, we call it this apply research. It's not scientific research because we try to create a research that result of the research can be applied, can be application for the concession. That's when the number of research studies show us this is the, by adopting of reduced impact logging, there can be reduced of the impact on the soil, impact and the hydrology, and impact of the social conflict. Because especially social conflict, most of people in the forest or living or surrounding on the concession, the using of the water river for the daily consumption. This is why by adopting of reduced impact logging, this is the impact of the hydrology is very minimized, and then water cannot be met. This is the good implementation of reduced impact logging for the community. And also at the same time, we do the research, and then last 10 years, as we know, the carbon issue is very popular. And that time we do the research, and then look like that the by implementation of the reduced impact logging can be reduced of emission and between 30 to 60% depend on the area. For example, in the Papua, because the human resource in the Papua a little bit below. Now let's compare in other part Indonesia. That's why the impact of the climate impact of the emission is very, very high to reduce in the Papua up to the 60%. And then also, in that same time, we develop of the forest market linking program. And that tool is very, very success. And that time, because there's a lot of the issue of illegal logging, and then the Samo country doesn't have any a standard to prove that the wood come from the legal source. And that time, the TFF Indonesia developed the standard, we call it the legal pre-prep program, and also combined with the implementation of reduced impact logging that we call real verified program. If the company has the certificate of real verified certificate, and then they can send the market, send the product to the market, especially the market in Europe and America, this accepted the certificate. This is just the, what we call it, the, this the we try to provide of the a good a concession, a good a company to do the good implementation of the reduced impact logging, also apply of the standard of the sustainable forest management. During the our program of forest market linking, that the certification, international certification standard start to come to Indonesia. And that time, the TFF Indonesia support to the FSC that we are very success to facilitate of the company to achieve our FSC standard. Up to now, we already facilitate, this is more than 30 concessions in Indonesia. And then that the already certified, this is more than 2 million hectares in Indonesia. That the very big successful for the TFF Indonesia. And then this, in Indonesia, many organizations, many NGO also the facilitate to the company to achieve of FSC Indonesia. But until now, I think the 70% of the certified concession under of TFF Indonesia facilitated. This is the what I would call it is very big successful. And then the people actually can asking whatever they try to achieve to TFF Indonesia, then we can facilitate. For example, any concession asking, can you facilitate us to achieve of FSC? Yes, we can do. Can you facilitate us to achieve of EFC standard? Yes, we can do, because our staff is very good knowledge regarding the standard of certification for the national, for international. This is why we are very flexible. As long as for the tropical forest, we're not working in the like the boreal forest and the like the temperate forest. We are just specified and looking in the tropical forest. The reduced impact logging in Indonesia and the region, I think especially Indonesia, not until now still continuing, because we are together with the nature conservation, we develop our standard, we call it real C, reduced impact logging carbon. This methodology already approved by the VCS PERA to audit, to verify that the company, if the implementation of reduced impact logging, they can reduce of the emission, and then that the emission or the can be sold to the international market. But now in Indonesia, we start to working with the Ministry of the Environmental and Forest to implement the methodology for the to helping of the government Indonesia to achieve of the NDC commitment by 2030. And then that until now, TPF Indonesia still operating. Even that we have the program in the Brazil and the Gabon look like it's very lightly and then the very slow. But Indonesia, we still operating and we still have the very big demand. This is why the TPF Indonesia, since the independent 2010, we are have the what we call it in the beginning is very unique organization. Even that we are independent, but we the TPF International give us the using of the logo. We have the same mission. We have same of the approach. It's not changed from the beginning. I think that the most of the activity of TPF Indonesia. And once again, that the in the early of 2020, during of the COVID, this pandemic, we don't have any lot of activity in the field. I am collaborating with the climate forest consulting. We try to looking of the how to strengthen of the real standard, because we have the real standard Indonesia that we can use to audit our concession. We're using the score. If the concession already get the score, like the 80%, that means the full implementation of the criteria of the reduced impact logging. If the only achieve like the 50%, that means the only following of the government regulation. From this engagement, we look at the TPF Indonesia is looking in the region of the Indonesia and the Asia Pacific, and we established the new organization. We call it the Alliance for Responsible Forest Management. This Alliance for Responsible Forest Management will be working in the Africa and also in the South and the Center of America. That now we already start engagement with the city. We start with engagement some organization in the Africa. I think that the historical of the TPF Indonesia, what we can explain it, and then I will once again thank you very much for the International Society of Tropical Forest to having the symposium. I hope this message can be brought and it can be achieved by and then to the any country in the world, and then if any concession still looking to helping to achieve of the sustainable forest management, especially to achieve as implementation of reduced impact logging, just call of the TFF, whether the TFF International or TFF Indonesia, we're happy to helping you. Thank you very much and happy symposium, and then good morning everybody. Thank you very much.